shame, God erases it. Isaiah 54 and verse 4. Do not fear, for you will not be ashamed, neither be disgraced, for you will not be put to shame. For you will forget the shame of your youth and will not remember the reproach of your widowhood anymore. Of course, God in this passage here in Isaiah 54 through the prophet Isaiah is speaking to his own people, and he is addressing an issue of barrenness, of them being unable to bear children, of seeing fruitfulness and so on. And then God speaks into their lives and says, look, I am going to enlarge the place of your tent. I'm going to cause you to expand. I'm going to cause you to abound, because I'm going to so bless you that more will be the children of the barren woman than the one who is married. In other words, God is going to so bless your lives that he's going to turn things around. And then he sums it up in this verse that we read in verse 4. He says, listen, don't be afraid, because you will not be ashamed. Don't be disgraced. Don't feel humiliated, because I'm not going to let you be in that place of shame. I will cause you to forget the shame of your youth, meaning your past, and you will not remember the reproach of those days of widowhood, of those days of barrenness and lack of fruitfulness and lack of success and lack of growth and lack of increase. I'm going to cause that reproach of that season of your life. I'm going to cause the shame of that stage of your life to be so taken away from you that you will forget it. You won't even remember the shame that was once upon your life. You see, this is what God does for us. He causes us to forget our shame. He brings us out. He erases that over our lives. And he does this by so blessing us, just reversing the circumstances in such a manner that what he puts upon our lives will cause us to just forget that we actually went through a season of reproach and shame. You know, think about Joseph. That's a great example that we see in the Bible. Think about the humiliation he went through from being his father's most loved son, being so honored in that family, to being sold as a slave, coming into a foreign land, having to do some, jobs that he probably was never accustomed to, and then being further humiliated and being put into prison. I mean, things couldn't have got worse than this. There was so much shame being put upon his life. And yet God turned all of that around, that he actually went from being a prisoner to becoming the prime minister of that land. God turned it around. And then when Joseph had his first son, he named him in this manner, saying, God has caused me to forget the pain and the labor and the toil that I went through. That means God has so touched my life, so blessed my life. He has erased the shame. He has removed the pain of whatever I've gone through. You know, God does this for us, and God can do this for you. It doesn't matter, you know, the season of shame, the season of reproach and humiliation that you may have gone through. There is a God in heaven who's got his eyes on you, and he's about to do what we just read. He's about to enlarge. He's about to bless. He's about to so change things around your life, he will cause you to forget your shame. He will erase it. Let's believe him to do that for you and me. Let's pray. Father, we thank you that you are such a great, big, powerful, and loving God, that you erase the shame of the past. Whatever caused it, the barrenness or unfruitfulness or lack or insufficiency or whatever it was, you erase it in such a way that we forget the pain. We forget the shame. Lord, for those who are listening, who may need this kind of touch in their lives, release it for them, I pray, in Jesus' name. Amen.
Thank you for tuning in to Living Supernaturally. For more resources to strengthen your spiritual walk, please visit apcwo.org.